video is designed to help you understand when you would use a dongle with a tape recorder. The term dongle is usually referring to a device that's used with computers as a security system for software. However, dongles existed long before computers did and were used with tape recorders from the early 1970s when they began to use an internal microphone and an ALC circuit to make recordings. This machine is the Panasonic Retro Red from the 1970s, and I don't have a video on this machine yet on YouTube, but I will be putting up one soon, so please keep looking at ClydeSight to find out all about this fascinating machine. Another type of cassette recorder that uses an internal microphone is a shoebox style cassette recorder. And here's the internal microphone, and this also has an automatic level control circuit. Other machines that also use a similar function are micro recorders. This is a General Electric micro recorder which has an internal microphone here. It also has a provision for an external microphone. This Olympus Pearl recorder is a micro recorder which has a built-in microphone, but you cannot use a dongle with this machine because the only jack that is here is an earphone jack. There is no microphone input jack. A dongle is simply a plug that does nothing, goes nowhere, and it is basically an open circuit. When it is inserted into the microphone input of a tape recorder, it creates an open circuit and it defeats the internal microphone. Because it's defeating the internal microphone with an open circuit, the automatic level control has nothing to pick up. Therefore, the automatic level control is also defeated. Thus, if you make a recording with this machine with the dongle inserted, it will put a blank spot on the tape. Now, be careful of making the assumption that you don't really need to do this, that you can just hit the record button and turn the volume control down all the way down. You have an ALC circuit that pays no attention to the volume control. It is sensitive to any kind of signal that is coming in. Making your own dongle is very easy. All you have to do is buy an adapter plug. This plug has a mini plug on one end and a jack on the other end to accept a quarter inch plug. This is a Y adapter which would work as a dongle with any cassette recorder that has a quarter inch jack. These little micro cassette recorders often use a micro plug, and of course you can get an adapter for that too. You do not have to buy a special dongle from any tape recorder manufacturer. The dongle is safe to use even though it has exposed metal part on the end, simply because this is a ground. So if you touch this, it's not going to make any difference to the machine whatsoever. That's very different from plugging in a cable and using that to create an open circuit, because the cable has both the ground and the hot lead exposed, and if you touch the hot lead, you'll put a buzz on the machine. And sometimes on some of these machines, if they're not that well shielded, the cable will act as an antenna and it will start to pick up some very weak radio signals in some cases. I'm now going to show you how to use a dongle to erase a section of tape. And for this demonstration, I'm using the Panasonic Red. I'm using the internal microphone on the Panasonic Red retro tape recorder, making a recording, testing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, testing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, no, no, I don't want to record this. Oh, I must erase this. I must erase this immediately. I have erased a section of the tape. This is the end of the demonstration. I did that for a reason, so we know what section to erase. So first we need to play back and find out what our recording does. I'm using the internal microphone on the Panasonic Red. This machine does not have a 3-digit tape index counter, so it's very hard to know where the tape starts and ends where you want to make the erasure. But you can do it if you can count to 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, you can do it that way. So we'll go back and we'll listen again, and then we'll start counting when I start saying, oh no, I want to erase this. 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh no, no, I don't want to record this. Oh, I must erase this. I must erase this immediately. I have erased a section of the... There's approximately 10 fingers or about 10 seconds, maybe a little bit less, that I need to erase. So again, we simply rewind.
Panasonic Red retro tape recorder, making a recording, testing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, testing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Alright, I know now that this is where I want to start erasing. So I plug my dongle into the microphone jack. I don't have to adjust anything on the volume, and I'm going to press a recording, and with my hand I will count to 10. Let's rewind to find out.
I'm using the internal microphone on the Panasonic Red retro tape recorder, making a recording, testing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, testing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh. Section of the tape. This is the end of the demonstration.
So that obviously was a very quick explanation on how to do that. May take some practice for you to get used to doing this, but basically that's how it works. Let's use our dongle to place a blank section on the tape. So even though I'm talking right now, and I'm talking as much as I like to, there is no recording being made because this is an open circuit right here. But I've made a blank section on the tape. So you can see that on this type of machine, a dongle is about the only way you're going to create a blank section of tape. It is only necessary when you have an internal microphone and an automatic level circuit. If you have a machine that has an internal microphone but does not have an automatic level circuit, turning down the volume will work. I hope you enjoyed this video and that it answered any questions you might have about how you could defeat the automatic recording that comes as a convenience in these machines. For the one time it's not convenient. Thank you for watching the video, and please keep watching ClydeSight channel, because I will have a video on the Panasonic Red showing you the entire mechanism. It's fascinating. I will also be doing a video on the General Electric shoebox tape recorder showing you this mechanism, which is equally fascinating.